Fox Luca e Sharper Trades. Well, a pretty bearish week. We haven't seen this in quite some time. In fact, we have to go back here a little bit of a pullback, and then this week down here in July. Now, this is a very significant pullback, and it looks quite bearish, frankly, with the Feds raising the interest rates significantly, 2 points. That was a huge shock to the market. This was the beginning of it, and then followed through yesterday and today. Now, today was way down. Price was down to 285, found support down there, and then was able to close above the 50. Now, this is a very important place, 287.67. Key resistance support now. Holding also the 50 simple and moving average. This area is a must hold. The 50 indicates it's one of the areas where the majority, most money managers pay attention to. Look, when price closes below this area, asset managers start going short, start closing positions, not generally going short, but closing positions. So we have already seen a significant amount of selling these 3 days. We might get a bounce next week. See a little bit of a bounce. I do expect that. But again, please be very careful because it's a very tentative market and we could have seen an inverted shoulder where this is the shoulder, the head, and this is the lower high, which will make the right shoulder, which could take the price further down to this area down here. I don't expect that to happen anytime soon, but we are heading towards tentative and treacherous territory. So I will be extremely careful moving forward. If you have positions, keep your position size small. Day trading is always a safer way to trade during these market conditions. And definitely, when you have profits, put it in your pocket, because again, this market is very volatile, very volatile, and a profit can turn into a loss very quickly. So this is the SPY. Let's see what next week brings. I look for a pop and a retest of 289.82 and hold above the 34 EMA, and hopefully we are on our way higher. But again, hoping in trading doesn't pay off. So let's see what happens. That's the SPY. The Nasdaq, it's a very grim scenario as well. Closing below the 50 yesterday and today continuing lower. So money shifted away from the Nasdaq, the technology sectors are paying the price. Let's see. So now we are testing some support. This could be the new rising channel. It's the base. So we'll have to see if this base holds. With regards to the Nasdaq, the next moving average in line is the 200. That's the red line. So that's way down here. We have some support down here at 76.42, and then down here at 74.40. I hope we won't get there. But again, this also looks like a left shoulder, head, and right shoulder pattern. So this is usually bearish sign, especially again with the Nasdaq price broke below the 50. Very dangerous. The Dow Jones Industrial looks better of the three, is the one that look better all for the past month. It is the one that has showed more strength compared with the other. So it looks decent, still holding the 26,000 support area at the 21 simple day moving average. So in the short term still looks good, but it's close below the 8. So every time price of any equity closes below that points to a little more bearish pressure in the short term period, week to a month. So we'll see what happens with this one. This is the top of a channel. It was a breakout a few days ago, and now it's retesting it. So this is an important area to pay attention to. The moving averages overall are holding pay attention also to the 50 down to 26,000. Because this is 26,405, that's 400 points. So let's see, overall, this one looks better. And finally, with regards to the indices, the small caps have rolled over, broke the mid channel, now down to the support at 160.54. We might get a bounce. This support is also here at the 200 simple the moving average and then the channel bottom. This is the small cap volume in down bar volume increasing, so there is tension in this market as well. This is the Russell 2000. So again, moving forward, it's something to be careful. I'm looking at the SPY now quickly in the after hour market. Looks it's holding the key support at 287.67. So let's see what next week brings. Now let's go to the individual stocks, things that have moved because of this serious drop in the market. Many of the stocks we were following that were doing very well got stopped out, broke the support, so we closed many positions, and today a few others also stopped working. So when you have this kind of drop and a little bit of a bounce, you want the stock that you're holding to do something similar, drop, okay, and bounce, or stay in the stay within the trading range, within the rising channel, or at least holding the support. So we'll take a look at all of the ones we're following, starting with the ADAP. ADAP, you see, this is the kind of things that is okay. The market came down significantly, didn't move much. In fact, they reached the target very close to 1476. That was the next target. Held support still above the ATMA and 1340. It's still inside the rising channel. So those are the things you pay attention to. Lateral support and trend line. If any of those get violated, close the position. Or if it drops below and bounce back inside, stay long as those areas continue to hold. Looking for a retest of 1450, a pop through this resistance right here. Our next target is 1628 and 1786. PKS, this was a day trade from yesterday. They did a little bit, not much, and today is extending. And this is now a new swing for the swing group as well. So it looks very good. Now, this is the market came down many points today, serious sell-off. This held the support. This is the kind of things you want to be in. So this has the potential to go much higher. I'm looking for, this is a breakout, first of all. Important breakout area. And 650. I'm looking for a target of 752, if we can pop 7 and hold, 713 and then hold. And then 838 and 958. Looks very good. BLDP still holding the support. It's above the $4 level. It's now below the ATMA. When I see that, it gets me a little uncomfortable. So we might see this pennant consolidation. Make sure 390 holds. This is the primary first support. Secondary support will be all the way down here to 250. So that's a significant drop. Look for a breakout of this trend line area. Maybe more like that. Yeah, and the next target will be a retest of this 454, which we reached very close to a few days ago. And then if we can break out of that, 528 and 591. CGNX, this clearly broke down. So this, we get it down here as a day trade, consolidate, and then broke out here as a swing trade and reached multiple targets at 58, 59.02, and then 59.18. So this is how you will trade something like this. It breaks out. Either you enter the position, full position, or you enter during the consolidation, half position. Then when it breaks out, you add position to it, half the remaining half. And then it goes, stay long as price continues to stay in above the ATMA. And then when it reaches the top of the channel, unless the thing blows through it and goes vertical, take the profit. This is the obvious place to take profit. What do you see the following day? If you're not convinced, there is a dark shadow, a dark cloud. So this tells us, take the profit. This is a sell signal. If you're not convinced, the following day opens lower. Close the position here. You want to close the full position? You don't have to close half, close a third. And then what does it do? Following day moves below the 8. If you're not convinced there, we had a stop at 58, first of all. First stop, secondary stop at 56. Came all the way down here and then bounced, formed a bear flag, and then the market is in the toilet. And those are the vulnerable ones that get slammed. And this is one of them. We have a few hours to pay to look at that. So this is out. But again, this is how you trade something like this. This CGNX now off the table. As well as CLDR. This we traded yesterday. Looked like it wanted to run a little bit. But today, when you get the spinning top is indecision. It's like a doji, a bigger doji. What do you do when you see a spinning top? You follow the direction of where the price opens the following day. It's an indecision. I don't know which way to go, up or down. If the following day it opens down, that points to the direction it wants to go. And then if in this case went up, test the resistance right there at 1927 and say, you know what? I'm going lower. So if you are in this position and you see that this is now a resistance, close that position because this is going to go down. It's made the decision to go down. And here it goes, all the way down to the 8. So this might have found the support, something, but we don't know. This is falling and it could come down to the bottom of the channel. If this falls, then it could go down to 16 and 15. So these are the kind of things you cannot predict, but you got to keep your stops in place and use the probability that the candlestick analysis and technical analysis gives us. So this increased probability that things will go down, it did go down. So this is now is also off the list. We'll see if something reverses. And this very similar, this very similar. So this consolidated for a month, more than that, 2 months. And then here we wanted to break above it, was holding nicely. Here was holding nicely. I was feeling kind of good about this, you know, 35 is holding, and then came here. It didn't quite reach 37, so that made me a little uncomfortable yesterday, but it was still above the 8, so that was good. And then today popped, but then immediately came down, and it came down, broke below the 8, broke below all the moving averages and the 50. So many of the stocks today did something similar, but then they bounced back up. These didn't. These stuck down there, stuck in bearish mode. So this is now off the list because it's below all the moving averages, the 50 especially, and closed below. We had a stop at 35, 30, closed below it, and now it's below this 34. So this is pretty bad. Sometimes equity managers manipulate price in such a way where they display a big drop one day. And then the following day, they pop it up to 42 or to 39, something like that. So that's always a possibility. This is something we don't know. We cannot know that kind of game that goes behind the scenes. But right now, it looks like it wants to go lower. And the bottom line is this: if you're not comfortable holding a stock that is down at certain percentage or to a certain price, close the position. Do you have to close the full position? No. If you still like the company and the chart and the pattern, close a smaller position, half, a third. But the bottom line, you have to be comfortable with what you're trading. DNR continues to hold. This is also one of those that are important to look. The market is rolling over and this is still holding. So this is one of the things, check, this is working. Even though BB is pointing down, the volume, there is down bar volume. Undoubtedly, they will sell off today in this company as well, but it's holding the support. So as long as 639 and this mid-channel area are holding, it's good. Looking for a pop above 672, target 719 and 8. And it's also consolidating yesterday, 2 days ago, ran as high as 1798, 96. Pullback consolidated, is still doing indecision. This indecision, which way do I go? OBV is above moving average, volume, the upper volume is good. It closed above these resistances 30, 1732, but we have another resistance here at 1747. So this area we need to pop up very quickly. And again, look at the HMA. As long as the area holds, it's good. If it breaks, consider closing the position on a behalf. There is this trend line right here and the lower channel down here. So a few areas to pay attention to. First stop, 17, secondary, 16.47. ENDP has now broke below the support at 458, and 50 is still a strong resistance. So there is one positive note here, the 200 simple moving average holding on the bottom of the channel down here. But right now, I don't like this chart at all. I broke the 8, I broke below 458, it's now down at the 200. The 200 is holding, but this breakout, when you see a breakout like this, it has to run. Pull back a little bit, but the 50 needed to hold, it didn't. So right now, I'm taking this off the list as well. I don't like what I see. Unless we see some kind of reversal next week, this for now is off. Hey, I like it. Broke out yesterday, pulled back today, tested the 17 area and the ATMA, close above the breakout area. The technicals look great, volume is good, OBV is pointing up, so the market is in the toilet. This is also affected a little bit, but it's holding. This is the key point. Support is holding. So let's see if the market reverses or something. This might stabilize for a few weeks or something. Hopefully, we'll start going very quickly next week. Look for a pop above 1773, and if we get and sticks, the pop sticks, we're looking for 1869 and 1992. Intelstat, well, this is impressive. It just continues to hold. This is today we see a down bar volume, not huge like here, so a little bit of sell off. It's Friday, but it's still holding the support, it's still holding above 33. So have a tight stop below today's low at 32, or a more loose one down here at 30. So those are the areas. You know, you can close half position if this moves below 32, and then close the remaining position if it closes below 30. This is one strategy you can use. Or if you're happy with this profit, which was up significantly since I gave you the alert down here at 24.30, close the whole position. Put the cash in your pocket. Or just let the thing run as long as it stays above the 8. Let the thing run until it reaches 40, because that's our next, our last target. So yeah, 34. 37 and 40, those are our next targets. So, see, different strategies. Only you know what you're comfortable with and what to do with that particular stock. I know today, so it broke out here, reached the target, resistance, pullback, now close below the 8. Again, I don't like that. But it's confirming the breakout of this trend line area right here and support at 530, it's holding. Now, 530 line in the sand must hold. If it breaks below this area, we'll roll down to 5, 487, 427 even. So that could be very dangerous. The breakout is still confirmed. I don't like the OBV is pointing down. So we must see still experiencing a consolidation. This looks like still a consolidation. There is some form of rising channel. So this could be something to... Let's actually do it this way. This could be something to pay attention to moving forward. So it could come down here. So again, be aware of this because, you know, when especially during this market condition, things can go down very quickly. But let's see. Overall, this looks good. Looking for a retest of 627, 7, and 764. INSEAD, another one that broke below, like many of them, but then didn't get the bounce. So when it doesn't get the bounce, out. So these, I'm taking it off the list. Okay? Candy, it's consolidating today. It's still holding okay. Had difficulties popping the 613, so it rolled down. It's still above the ATMA and above the trendline channel, the support trendline channel. So I'll see if we can pop the 613 and stick. Next target, 703 and 821. Technicals down here look great. MDXG, this is a bearish signal. It's a bearish kicker, close this position. Today you have to close this position. When I send in the pre-market that this company has been manipulating the price of a medication for VA hospitals. So just for that, they deserve to go down. So close the position. And when you see this kind of pattern, with price breaks below the trend line and start going down, exit. So this is now will probably drop down to 5 and potentially even 4.15 and 4.20. Out. Moss, it's holding the support. So this is 33 and the ATMA holding. Make sure this is a hold. This is a key support area. If he opens lower, comes up, test the 33, start moving down, it will go down. It points lower. So be careful with that kind of stuff. This has been up a few points already since the breakout through this area. 3 points. So, and reached 34, with the target was 34.50, very close to it. So let's make sure this 33 holds and keeps on going, and looking for a retest of 34.50 and 36. QNST, today, this was a day trade that at the beginning worked very well, actually reached the target. And by the way, I've changed some of the things within the way I send the alerts. And instead of paying a lot of attention to the pre-market and let you know what I'm watching, this is the support, this is the resistance, I'm gonna modify that a little bit by watching certain things. And then when I see this, that a price is breaking above the resistance and it's holding support a few minutes after the market open, 10, 15, 20 minutes after, then I will send you the alert. We just keep it clear. So there will be fewer alerts, more precise, to the point, instead of you figuring out what the support and the resistance is and what to do in this area. We are dealing with day trading. Day trading can be more risky. If you don't know what you're doing. So I'm modifying the way I send alerts to better fit your needs. And please send me an email, sharpertrades@gmail.com. Let me know what you think. If you have any suggestions, comments, I'm here to help you. Let me know. Okay, so this is, I saw this pop at the beginning, popped up in the volume buzz, and then consolidated, held the VWAP and then popped. So I sent you the alert through this area at 1460, and we had the first target at 1512. So we ran all the way up there, very close to it, and then came down. So this consolidation, if this is a trend channel, it needed to hold. Okay? This is the thing you want to pay attention to. It's a trend channel, it must hold. And then we see a little bit more volume right here. Now, this means, either way, either go up or down. There is more volume, big volume, compared to the others. This could go either way. In this case, it was the catalyst to push the price lower. And then here came the sell-off. This area fell. This was the first support we had. Stop at 1450, 1440. It fell, and then rollover. Bear flag, and rollover. And this came down, broke multiple supports. So this was off here. As a day trade, as a swing trade. Well, as a swing trade, frankly, I do like the bounce that it got towards the hand. The bounce looks good, but close below a very important support at 1396. Down sidebar volume. So this is something to watch next week. It looked like it was breaking out of this area today, early in the day. But then it's still a breakout. So let's see, if this is a breakout, we do consider this still a breakout of this trend line right here with up bar volume, that's positive. But if you do like this company, make sure it can move above the 50 simple moving average, which is 14, and then pops the flag and goes. So there are several resistances that can make this quite a tricky trade next week, but it's possible. The news was positive, very important upgrade by an analyst. So we'll see. Right now, I'm taking this off. Well, I'm gonna keep it on the list, but it's not, it's just something to watch right now because it's treacherous. SGH. Now, these are the kind of day trades you want to jump in, especially when you see the market in the toilet the way it is, and this one didn't flinch an inch. It just stayed steady and strong. This is the kind of stuff you want to be trading. So it popped right away in the pre-market, held right after the opening, held the support nicely, big volume, reached the resistance at 35, pullback. So a disassembly alert around here at 33.70, somewhere around that. Where popped above 34, pullback, held, and reached the target, 34.99. We had a target at 35.20, something like that. So a lower, because that became the new resistance. Consolidated the VWAP, held the support, and moving forward, it just stabilized. It came down to 33, held the support, went up. So this is the kind of consolidation that lasts the entirety of the session. And then towards the end, tried to pop the 35 support, the resistance fell, and so came down, retested the 33, held the support, and then into the close, it's above the moving averages and above 34. So overall, this is a very good breakout. Now, this has been up significantly, 25% from this point right here when it was 31 up to 34. So it might have to pull back and consolidate a little bit, but if you do like this company, this is a serious breakout. Here is what I'm looking for: a pop above 35 next week and a run to 37. This is the new target. Where you find the 200 simple moving average. And if you can break out of that, 39.27. Now, this is something that has been done significantly. In April, it was 56. And then yesterday was down 26.50, okay? Half. So this is a big breakout. Might have to consolidate a little bit, which is a possibility. Primary support, 33.23. Secondary support down here at 31.50. Now, this move significantly, so be aware of the risk. When you have this kind of stocks, maybe keep your position small. TRVN, these are the nice trade on Thursday, and then on Wednesday. And then yesterday, a scare all the way down to 264, but then was able to bounce and close above 287. This was our secondary support that needed to hold, and it did, because it closed right above it. And it's still consolidating, it's closing above the 3MA. So I'm getting the feeling that this is going to consolidate like this, form a platform. As long as the 290 holds, the price continues to close above it. This is a good chart, as well as the 8MA. Look at that as well. So looking for a breakout, maybe this is a pennant. We'll see. Forms a pennant like that. And if it breaks out of this trend line, we could see a run. Let's see. As long as it doesn't make a flag, because that will bring the price down further. So we could have a pennant, a triangle, something like this. And if you see a pop above this area and hold, looking for a retest of this resistance at 269, and pretty close a few days ago, 257, 4 and 448. Tesoro continues to move. This one is impressive. I love this chart breakout here. Give you the alert down here. It was very powerful and it continues to impress. So BB points up, the technicals look great. And from a technical point of view, this is a consolidation. So we are seeing a consolidation, and yet this thing keeps on going. So today reached the target 34, 43, 14, was 43, 23, and the mid-channel. See if you can pop through that. Next target 44, 56. 53 and 46.21. Looks good. Make sure 41 and then 40 down here holds. First and secondary support. Vale. Okay, though, so this was a breakout. Ran yet 2 days ago. Pretty close to the target at 16.22 in the pre-hour market. But then came down. Yesterday closed below the closed right at the 8MA. Today closed below it. So it's right at the support. Now, this, when I see these kind of things, I generally close the position because this is a breakout. The thing needs to hold. I'm sorry, no excuses. It didn't. Came down, closed below the 8. The OBV is now below the moving average. Dunbar volume increasing. The only positive sign that I can think of is that it's holding the support at 14.74, and that's it. So I don't like this. I'm going to take it off the list. If I see some kind of reverse or something changing, I'll let you know. But for now, this, for me, it's off the list. If you like the company and if you like what they're doing, hold it. VIAV, powerful breakout, ran to the top of the channel, pull back. Same story. When it reaches the top of the channel, what do you do? If you see a blow through, stay long. If you see a pull back, at the beginning of it, like we saw yesterday, especially during these market conditions, close the position, exit. Yeah. Now, this one, it's in the sector that is on the momentum with the communication equipment and the G5 technology. So I'm looking for a retest of the ATMA at 12, must hold. And if it doesn't, it will pull back down to 1182, 89. And if that doesn't, it will come down and test the trend line again. But overall, the technicals look good. This is a little bit of a sell-off. It's a clear breakout. We can also draw a mid-channel, which is the next support area you might want to look at. And again, that comes down here below 12. So be careful with this kind of pullback. But overall, the chart is still very bullish. And finally, ZFGN. So this made a significant move when I sent you the alert about the breakout around here. And then it ran nicely from 940 all the way up to wave 1, wave 2, wave 3, wave 4, wave 5, all the way up to 1255. So this is a significant move in just a few days. Let's see, 29 points. That's a huge percentage. So I hope you took your profit along the way, because now this has pulled back further than expected. Well, then not expected, but further than I wanted to see it. Didn't get the bounce like the others. It's now back down at 10.42, broke the support, this trend line support. And it's now testing 10. So 10, if it holds, that's good. We might get a bounce. I'll give you a re-entry opportunity. But if it fails, it will come down and test the channel right here. So we'll see. Anyway, for now, I'm taking also these off the list because it has violated my first support, 1133, and did not return above it. All right, folks, again, next week, let's see if we get some kind of a pop in the market. But again, it's a very bearish and volatile market, so be very careful. Enjoy this weekend, and we will see you on Monday. Good trading.